Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If I take you to the Bible in the book of Jeremiah, don't tell your Bible that I haven't started. If I take you to the book of Jeremiah 1 verse 4, the Bible says, and God said, before you were formed in your mother's womb,
yes.
God said, I know you.
Yes.
Long before your mother will meet your father in a corner or in the alley or somewhere behind any closed door for anything to happen, God said, I already know you.
Yes.
He just doesn't know you, but knowing you, he has you in his thoughts, in his plan. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So, nothing in life just happens. For everything that happens, God is already premeditated it. Phantom has a long detailed thoughts about it before it ever happens. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you read the Bible in the book of Genesis 12, when God called Abraham, God told Abraham that he should travel somewhere. God said, I am going to bless you.
Amen.
He says, I will make you into a great nation. Listen very intently. I will make you into a great nation. He says, whoever blesses you, I the Lord, I will bless that individual.
Amen.
And if anybody ever curses you, I the Lord, I will curse the individual. So if you are sitting here as a child of God, whether you are poor, broken, sick, or in any trouble, no matter how the circumstances is, you are blessed.
Amen.
So I want you to put your hand on your chest and announce yourself that I am blessed.
Amen.
Tell yourself,
I am
blessed.
Yes.
God called Abraham. Abraham was about 75 years old. His wife Sarah was very old. The two of them, if it's today, they will call them their barren. And I said, "Come here." He said, "Bear man, no sobano, but I put the end." Abraham, but God called them very late. But listen to what God said unto him. He says, "I will make you into a great nation. An old man with an old woman that has menopause, and a man has woman pause." And listen, the two of them, God is telling them that even in your old age, I will bless you and I will make you into a great nation.
Amen.
When Abraham started out, through the prophecy of Abraham, then came Isaac. Through the prophecy of Abraham, then came Jacob. Through the prophecy of Abraham came Joseph. When Joseph went into Egypt as a slave, it was pain, it was trouble. But nobody ever dreamt that through his pain, the prophecy that God pronounced on Abraham was coming to pass. I have often said that when you're going through trouble and things are not right, stop blaming God and stop hurting your heart. For it is through affliction that we see the finger of God perform miracles in our life. Amen. So when Joseph went into Egypt, then Jacob also joined his son Joseph in Egypt. Through that, then the prophecy of God came into pass. They now landed in Egypt as a small group of people, as a family. After a long time of pain and trouble, after a long time of suffering, God, through his powerful hand, he delivered all of them from Egypt to their promised land. Amen.
Amen.
When they were in Egypt and they were suffering, nobody ever thought about them. When they were suffering through slavery, poverty, hardship, and difficulty, nobody ever envied them or troubled about them. Do you know this time that you're struggling and you're going through stuff, nobody cares about you? Nobody worries about the car you're driving in. Nobody worries about your children. But the moment God begins to bless you, people begin to phantom and to calculate in a shoe you wear. Somebody say amen. One thing is that a long time ago, God has pronounced blessings upon their children. And some of you hear the blessing or the good things you're experiencing in your life today, it's not because you're good. Maybe something just because of one kindness of your mom. Just one good thing that your father did can really bless you today and transform your life. I am preaching on the topic, you are blessed.
Yeah.
Somebody say, I am blessed. And can you please point your finger to the person next to you and tell the person, you are blessed. 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 Prophesy to the person, you are blessed. Prophesy to the person, you are blessed. Prophesy, tell her, I prophesy to you. I prophesy to you. I prophesy to you. In the name of Jesus, 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 that you are blessed, that you are blessed, that you are blessed, that goodness and mercies shall follow you all the days of your life, oh you are blessed, oh you are blessed, oh you are blessed. You are blessed. Somebody give me a medal. Amen. Even if you are praying in Egypt, God still bless you. Even sometimes you go through stuff, you think God is abandoning, but God is still blessing. The fact that you're suffering poverty today doesn't mean that you're not blessed. The fact that things are not going right for you in your life doesn't mean you are in trouble. There's a blessing that is hanging in the atmosphere for you. The Bible says in God's own time, he makes all things. So let me tell you, if you've been taking a bus and you go through the subway and you can't find your way out of the subway, it doesn't mean that God is not blessing you. There's a blessing that is hanging in the atmosphere and it's coming your way. 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 God is blessing Israel. They are locked down in Egypt. Pharaoh has become a king and an authority. Like somebody, you are blessed so much, but to hear am I a girl? A brother named Sonia said, "You're the best one." Hey, you have found yourself as you said. You have found yourself who? And you are getting no more daddy. I'm happy. You say you are getting no more number daddy. I'm happy. Trouble. What God said about them wasn't that he was going to keep them in slavery. God said to Abraham that I am going to take you to a land, a place somewhere with a definition. So, just like anything else in life, the beginning is always rough. That is why the Bible says in the book of Jeremiah 29, he says, I know that what I have about you, it is good, not just good in the beginning, but it said in the ending it shall be good. It will be a year when my chest and I am passing, but the Christmas of God said, when we are here, we are Jesus Christ, and I'm a year in the name of God. So, can I say amen? How long while I preach the message? The Bible said, after they suffered so much in Egypt, now God opened the door for them to go to their promised land. But on their way to their promised land, God blessed them. Because the blessing started not today, it started from the time of Abraham. So they were on their way. If you go to the Bible in the book of Numbers 22, everybody turn the Bible there. Numbers 22 verse 1. Numbers 22 verse 1. It started from 1, Numbers 22. Mama, you can read.
Numbers 22. Then the Israelites traveled to the place of Moab and compared along the Jordan.
Hold on, that's the only word I want to hear. Listen, after God is blessing Israel, listen very intensely. After God is blessing Israel, and they were setting out to the promised land, the Bible says, and they traveled. Meant that they started moving from one place of struggle to another place of blessing. But on their way to go to their promised land, the Bible said a king saw them. Somebody saw them from afar. Because Israel were moving, the Bible said the person became jealous and the person made every effort to curse the people of Israel.
Amen.
When God prophesied on Abraham was a zero man. But through the prophecy, little by little, the prophecy came to pass. The Bible says while they were traveling in the region of Moab, Israel were blessed. They had now left Egypt in their struggle and pain, and they were moving on to a place of their promised land. Because there was a blessing, the Bible says somebody saw them and the person became envious or jealous. This is the reason why most of us Africans, we suffer a lot. When you are struggling, people don't care about you. When you are going through pain, when you are going through school and you are struggling, when you are doing things and you are struggling, the moment somebody observes that you are now moving on in life, Africa baby. The moment anybody observes that today there is an improvement in your life, things are getting better. They don't know where you are coming from in Egypt. They don't know the pain that you've been through in your life. They don't know the struggles you've been through. All that they are concerned about is that they see that you have been blessed. And somebody gets jealous. The Bible said there was a man called Balak. When he saw them, he became jealous. His intent was to stop them. His intent was to block them from getting to their promised land. And this is why most of us will suffer so much. Somebody just observed, said, somebody just saw them, just been blessed, just been gifted, just been anointed, and somebody gets jealous. And they are making every effort to stop Israel. But listen, no matter how the devil is fighting, if you are here, your blessing is not today. God's blessings upon your life is not by accident. It is through your grandfather Abraham. The blessing has been given to you a long time ago. The grace has been given to you a long time ago. The anointing has been given to you a long time ago. Nobody can stop your blessing. Nobody can block your blessing. Nobody can frustrate your blessing. Nobody can turn your blessing. Nobody can stop your blessing. Nobody can dance your blessing. Nobody can stop you. 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 Amen. Listen, the Bible said when Balak saw them moving, then he went to call a prophet called Balaam. He sent a message to Balaam that, come, I have seen some people moving. But if you are standing at the same place, they don't care. My sister, if you are just still at the same place, nobody cares. But let them observe some improvement and some betterment. They will bring every witch, they will bring every demon, they will bring every curse to destroy you. But I'm here to announce you that no demon, no witch, no principality, no devil, nobody can stop the blessing of God upon you. Nobody can stop the blessing of God upon you. Nobody can stop the blessing of God upon you. Nobody, 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 nobody. Pronounce a curse,
yes,
to stop the people of Israel.
Yes.
But my sister, however you see or however somebody sees you, the blessing that God gave you, before you were forming your mother's womb,
yes,
He's already made it.
Amen.
Before you were forming your mother's womb,
yes,
the blessing is already upon you. I said, nobody can stop your blessing. 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 Nobody. you still had your $6.50 job. They look at you. But the moment they see you qualifying to become a nurse or somebody,
Jesus.
Now all the witches what are you for me? I will yes, you yes, what you Yes, Roger. Yes, Roger. Yes, Roger. Yes, Roger. Yes, Roger. Yes, Roger. Yes, Roger.